Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. So it's early 2020 and we're going to do our first GPU showdown of the year. So this first GPU showdown will be a mid-range GPU battle between Team Green, which is a MSI RTX 2060 Ventus Access OC, versus Team Red. This is a also MSI 5600 XT Mac OC card. Right now we're going to do a very simple walkthrough of the cards. I'm going to get Gordon in to give you a run through of both cards, and after that we're going to show the numbers between Team Green versus Team Red. So Gordon, please take it away.
Thanks Mel. So before we go into the review itself, I think some of you may be asking the question, which is, why have we picked these two GPUs as mid-range? I mean, if we were to compare with, let's say, what we previously defined as a mid-range GPU, these guys are sit in a higher price bracket, etc, etc. So why would we pick these two? It's mainly because things have changed quite a fair bit in the last 3 to 4 years, I would say that. To elaborate a bit more on that, let's go back a bit in time. It's 2017. Your mid-range customer probably has a 24 or 27 inch 1080p monitor. It's probably 60Hz, because back then a gaming monitor with adaptive sync and 144Hz would probably have been significantly more expensive. So back then in 2017, what you would define as mid-range would be a GPU that can do 1080p, high or ultra, at least 60fps. Back then, you had two options. From Team Green, you had the GTX 1060 6GB. From Team Red, you had the RX 580 8GB. So both of these cards did fine. If you bought them in 2017, congratulations. If you paired it with your 1080p 60Hz monitor, you will be pretty happy. Because no matter which game you had at that point in time, you flipped all the details into ultra to maximum, whatever, you are going to maintain at least 60fps. Life was good. Now it is 2020. Things have changed quite a fair bit. 1080p 144Hz monitors have become much more affordable. To put things in perspective, I'd just like to show one example. In 2017, a typical 1080p 60Hz monitor, I'll just quote an example, Dell SE2417, that would have been the range of like SGD $150. If you wanted to go for a 1080p 144Hz monitor in 2017, 24 inch, it would have been somewhere in the region of like 400 SGD. Now, we fast forward this to the present day. Monitor prices have considerably dropped. A 24 inch 144Hz monitor, like let's say the MSI, the optic range, the 24 inch would probably set you back about 250 SGD. The 27 inch, you could probably get for about 350 SGD. Note the price drop from 400 3 years ago to 250. So what does this mean for today's gamers? It means 1080p 60fps is no longer enough. Their tastes have upgraded, for lack of a better word. What you want for mid-range now is you want not only 1080p ultras, you want much more than 60fps. This is the reason why we have picked these two are going to be the new mid-range. So now I'm going to move on to the part where I describe these two GPUs and what are their features and all that. First off, I like to look at cooling themselves. So if you look at the two cards, both have two fans, but the 5600 XT has larger diameter fans on it. This is also a much longer GPU, but I'm not saying much longer, but just quite a fair bit longer. So this might be one thing to take into consideration if you were to consider either of these two cards for, let's say, a more compact ITX or MATX build. Somewhat related to them will be the width that which they take up, if I were to tilt them side by side. So if you were to look at the two of them, the RTX 2060 is a two slot card, so it's exactly two slots. So if you were to end up in the situation like video that we did with the 2060 Super versus the RX 570 Non XT, this card will be advantageous if, let's say, you're in a small build where you have one more expansion card right next to it. You can install, let's say, a Wi-Fi card, a sound card right next to it. This one, on the other hand, due to the size of its cooler, it protrudes out a bit more the slot itself. So what this ensures for you is that in a small build, for example, wouldn't be able to put an expansion card right here. You have to leave this one slot blank, and then your expansion card goes here. For I/O itself, both of them is pretty similar for the record. Both of them have a single HDMI 2.0 port, and both of them have three DisplayPort outputs. For some of you folks with older monitors with, let's say, DVI inputs, that kind of thing, might have to resort to converters, but you do have to consider that these two cards are best paired with, let's say, a 1080p 144Hz monitor, especially if you want to take advantage of the AMD FreeSync or the NVIDIA equivalent, the G-Sync. Your monitor should be using DisplayPort. So yeah, this is a good move forward for MSI, so at least you would be able to hook up a theoretical maximum of 4 monitors, 3 of which are the most advanced display output, which is DisplayPort. And also, if you come to the back, both of them come with nice backplate down here, giving the card some much needed rigidity, especially for the longer 5600 XT. In terms of like embellishments such as RGB lighting and other sorts of bling, both of these cards don't quite have that. They are quite simple, no frills. If you're looking for that sort of thing in the MSI range, let's say the RTX 2060, there is the RTX 2060 Gaming Z. And for the equally colorful cousin from Team Red, there is the 5600 XT Gaming X. Both the Gaming Z as well as the Gaming XT are not available in Singapore as of this point, but they may be available in your particular locale, so you may probably want to check on that. So now on to our test setup itself. First and foremost, we have the AMD Ryzen 5 3600 here, sitting on an MSI D450 Pro VDH Plus motherboard itself. We have 16 gigs of GSteel Flare X 3200MHz CL16 RAM, and we have a 1TB ADATA SX6000 Pro SSD inside here. Now you may probably be wondering, why are we using mid-range components for the test setup itself? Well, the logic would be pretty simple actually. If you're gonna spend about $450 to $500 on a graphic card, your probable cost of your setup, likely for a good balanced setup, probably be in the region of like SGD 1.2, 1.3K. We are running these benchmarks in a real life scenario, you know, where a GPU like this is gonna end up. So that's the reason behind the hardware pick that we picked for the benchmarks. So this is the part where we go to the numbers. First off, we have CSGO, a very popular esports title, which is a game based on a very old engine, not very particularly multi-threaded in terms of like CPU usage, but it makes use of the GPU quite a fair bit. You can see right over here, both GPUs are pretty much on par with each other. There are certain points in the video where the Radeon is a little bit higher, a little bit lower, that kind of thing. Generally speaking, for CSGO, if you were to pick either one of these, you're gonna get in excess of 300 FPS, way above even what a 144Hz monitor is gonna do for you. So yeah, it's a tie for the both of them. For the next game, we have decided to use Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six Siege. For this particular game, we have taken the ultra preset of the game. But we have made one little tweak other than turning the VSync off. We have adjusted the render scaling from the default 50% to 100%. Now, what does this mean? At the default setting of 50%, what it will do is that it will show you at 1920 by 1080 Full HD, but it will actually render at 1366 by 768. While it gives you more FPS, it drops the image quality. So what we've done is we've set it to 100%. It will render at Full HD, it will show onto your screen at Full HD. Now, getting that out of the way, now you can see right over here that the Nvidia card consistently seems to be performing just that a little bit better than the Radeon 5600 XT. Now, this might be a bit different from a lot of the benchmarks that were run when the 5600 XT was on its initial launch, when the Radeon had the edge. I presume this is the difference we're seeing here is probably due to some tweaks that Nvidia has done to their current latest drivers. Next, we go on to another Tom Clancy game. This time, it's Division 2. What we've done is that we have set the settings to 1080p, Ultra Preset, with the only change from the Ultra Preset being VSync being turned off. So as you can see right over here, the Radeon is pushing out just a little bit more frames on average. You can probably see in the final results, the Radeon 5600 XT comes out with a slight edge with a score of just a bit over 80 FPS compared to the 2060s mid 75, 76 like that. This is something that you probably won't be able to see in actual gameplay. I mean, the important thing for a normal player would be both of these will deliver to you well above 60 FPS in normal gameplay. For the fourth title we are going to benchmark, we have decided to bring in Battlefield 5. Now, since this game doesn't quite have a benchmark mode like the three previous ones, what we've done here is that we have taken single player campaign mission, The Last Tiger, And we're gonna run you through as we storm through Berlin in the Tiger Tank. Can see right over here, other than the CPU usage being quite heavy, what you can see in this benchmark over here is the Nvidia card pumping out just that a little bit more FPS than the 560 XT itself. Settings wise, what we've done is pretty simple. We have set it to Ultra preset, and we have turned the VSync off. For the Nvidia card, we have set ray tracing off as well as DLSS to make this a more fair comparison, since the Radeon card naturally does not have ray tracing and DLSS. For this particular benchmark, much like the Division 2 itself, we have set it to DX12. Now, some of you may be wondering why we don't put it to DX11, because it is in my view that one should benchmark and gauge a GPU today based on a current day API rather than a last gen API like DX11. So yeah, in conclusion, the Nvidia card is just a little bit faster in this benchmark. Okay, finally for the last one, we've decided to take a look at another popular esports title, this one, Apex Legends. Like the previous four games, we have cranked up the settings all the way to the highest that you can go in. Again, like Battlefield 5, since it doesn't quite have a benchmark mode, what we've done is we're gonna run this game through the firing range mission itself. So as you can see from the graphs on the top left, you can see that the Nvidia card has the slight edge right over here as well. You're probably looking at about maybe 5% performance difference between the two of them. Like let's say in the situation, like let's say where the Radeon may do 90 FPS, the Nvidia card will be doing like 95 to 100 FPS. So you're probably looking at about 5 to 10% difference between the two cards itself.
Right, so we'll run you through the numbers of these 5 games. So Gordon, can you let us know like what you think of these two cards and which one will you choose to recommend to your customers or any people who want to build a PC out there?
Okay, first off, couple of comments I would like to make. The benchmarks, some of the results were quite a fair bit surprising, especially if you compare them to the data from other reviewers on YouTube, especially initially when this guy, the 560 XT, launched. Yeah, it seems there have been quite a fair bit of fluctuations as to which of these two is the faster two in any given game itself. For example, in most reviews, when the 560 XT first launch, that guy was a little bit faster, but now it turns out that this guy is a little bit faster in the Division 2. For Rainbow Six, it's the other way around. When this guy came out, Rainbow Six was a little bit faster on this guy rather than the 2060, but now it seems, as you can see from our test itself, this guy is the faster of the two in Rainbow Six Siege. So what does this tell you? Both Team Green and Team Red playing a little game of tit for tat with each other when it comes to optimizing their drivers for the various titles like CSGO, Rainbow Six, Battlefield 5, that kind of thing. So the results that we have gathered here today are correct as of today. I won't be surprised if we were to run this bunch of tests, let's say 2 to 3 months from now, and then some things turned out to be quite a fair bit different. Having said that, however, if I were to pick between these two, I'll pick the RTX 2060. This guy. As to why. Again, like in the video that I commented in previous video we did, the drivers for the GeForce card are just simply much more polished, they're more stable, they're much more features. This guy, the recent Radeon 2020 drivers have improved quite a fair bit since that review a few months back. But it's still got some work to do. So for the Radeon team, please keep it up. We can see improvement, but there's more room for improvement. Yeah. Having said that, however, I'm not gonna say that this guy is don't buy. I will just put it this way, that that guy in the Singapore context is SGD 499. This guy over here is 459. So that's a 40 SGD difference. Now, if 40 SGD can mean the difference between, let's say, entry-level motherboard and a mid-range motherboard, for example, or it could mean the difference between, let's say, having a 250 gig boot SSD and a 500 gig boot SSD. If you're working on a budget, you can go for this guy. You may encounter a bit of hiccups at this point in time, but going as the way the Radeon team is working, I do believe that this will prove to be a very competitive card versus the RTX 2060. So, in short, while in my personal opinion, I think that's the better of the two as of this point in time. This might change. But as of right now, if you can stretch to 499, get this fella. If you're a little bit tight on budget, get this fella, save that $40,
You can't go wrong.
Either way, you're gonna get a GPU which will give you well above 60 FPS in most games at 1080p today, no matter how high you crank up the settings. So if you pair either of these with, like I said earlier in the video, a 1080p 144Hz monitor, you're gonna be in for a very fun time for the next, I'll say, 2 to 3 years.
Yes, so this is our first graphic card battle for the year, so definitely look out for more graphic cards battle when more graphics cards come out, right?
Yeah, definitely look forward to that. I mean, especially with AMD Radeon division is gonna drop big Navi. Yeah, I'm gonna love to put that guy against, let's see, a 2070 Super, 2080 Super from the Green Camp. Yeah, that's gonna be a battle for the titans.
2080 Ti has been the king for too long. We need to something to bring him down.
I wouldn't say that, but we have something that can stand toe to toe with the 2080 Ti. That will be awesome.
Cool.
Because it gives customers like you much more options.
Alright, cool.
Yeah.
Let me know in the comments what other GPU showdowns you want to see, what other GPU pairings you want to know, write in the comments below. So if you like this video, give us a thumbs up, and if you have not done so, make sure to subscribe to our channel by clicking on the eye icon, check out our playlist, and click on the bell to know when we put up new videos. Yeah, thank you. This is Gordon and I out. Bye!